Hey everyone, Sunil here with DataLocker to highlight some of the key features of SafeCrypt, our encrypted virtual drive application. SafeCrypt is our cross-platform compatible solution managed by Safe Console that uses a FIPS 140-2 validated encryption engine and reflects our commitment to a simply secure approach that ensures that your data is secure no matter where you store it. SafeCrypt puts full control of your data back in your hands by using locally stored encryption keys, which is the only way to decrypt your data. There are no master decryption keys stored in the cloud or anywhere here at DataLocker, which ensures that your secured data is truly your secured data. We're not going to walk through the installation itself, but rest assured that we've worked hard to make it as simple as possible to install and register a SafeCrypt drive in a way that best fits your workflow. Everything from individual installations to mass deployment with silent installations, we've got you covered. Check out the links at the end of this video for more in-depth details on deployment options for your environment. Now, here's what creating a SafeCrypt drive looks like. Once SafeCrypt is installed on your workstation, you can create your encrypted virtual drive in whatever location is best for you. This could be a local folder, a secure flash drive, or even a folder that is synchronized to any cloud platform of your choosing. SafeCrypt still handles all the encryption and ensures that securing your data is as simple as saving it to your encrypted virtual drive, just like you would with one of our secure flash drives. Once the data is stored within your SafeCrypt drive, you can see that the actual files themselves are fully encrypted within the storage location. Now let's check out what you as the Safe Console administrator can access and control. From the Safe Console dashboard, you can view any SafeCrypt drive by clicking on Manage Drives from the left-hand side, and then searching for SafeCrypt drives within that table. Click on the name of the user that the drive is tied to, and then on the serial of the SafeCrypt drive to bring up the details. From here, you can modify the policy to configure things like the password policy or any file restrictions you want in place, either a whitelist or a blacklist. You can also change the status of the drive, where you can quickly and simply deny access or re-enable access to a SafeCrypt drive. You can perform a reset password. This is for users that have forgotten their password to their SafeCrypt drive. And finally, you can see the recent actions which have taken place within the SafeCrypt drive. Now, each SafeCrypt drive takes up a single license, regardless of the size of the storage location, which makes it easy for you as the administrator to ensure that the data is kept secure, no matter where it's being stored. Well, thanks for watching, guys. If you're interested in more information or would like to set up a trial of SafeCrypt, be sure to hit up our website at safecrypt.com.